Chapter 4, Section 2, Divisibility and Prime Factorization. You're going to learn some great divisibility rules here, and if you will take the time to memorize them, they will make your life so much easier in the future. If you choose not to take the time to memorize them, then you can suffer when trying to divide and find common factors and things of that nature. It doesn't bother me, but it'll bother you. Oh, my thing died. Let me bring it back up here. Meanwhile, divisible. A number is divisible by a second number if it can be divided by that number without any remainders. All right, that's a pretty straightforward definition. For example, 10 is divisible by 2 because it goes into it precisely 5 times. However, 10 is not divisible by 3 because there would be a decimal or a fraction mixed number left over. Divisibility rules. A number is divisible by. First line, no, that's not a negative, that's just a hyphen. A number is divisible by 2 if the number is even. That one you should have learned like in baby school. A number is divisible by 3, this one's pretty darn cool, if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. Example, say you had 39, 3 plus 9 is 12, 12 is divisible by 3, so the whole thing is. It does not matter how many digits you have, you could have a gazillion digits in there, and if you add them up and it equals the number divisible by 3, then the whole thing is divisible by 3. Pretty sweet. 4 is the number formed by the last two digits. If that number is divisible by 4, the whole thing is. So let's take 48,512. We're going to look at the 12 value right here. If the 12 value is divisible by 4, which it is, goes into it 3 times, then you know the whole number is. Easy math. 5, another number, concept you should have learned in baby school. If it's got a 0 or a 5 on the end, it's divisible by 5. 6 is a pretty cute one. If you checked and it was divisible by 2 and it was divisible by 3, both of them, then it's also going to be divisible by 6. And if you think about it, the factors of 6 are what? 2 and 3. Easy math. 7 has no rule. 7's the awkward red-headed stepchild. I hope none of you are red-headed stepchildren, but if you are, I'm not picking on you. It's the one that has no friends here. It has nothing that we like. You're just going to have to grind the 7's out. It can be painful, but hey, that which does not kill you makes you stronger. 8 is very similar to the 4's rule, only it involves the last 3 digits. If the last 3 digits is divisible by 8, then the whole thing is. And you can see that here in 5,484. Look at your last 3 digits. If that last 3 is divisible by 8, then the whole thing is. Easy math. The 9's rule is very similar to the 3's rule. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, the whole thing is. Take, for example, 3,249. Add those up, we got 18. Is 18 divisible by 9? Of course it is. Therefore, we know the whole value is divisible by 9. Easy math. Anybody can do this stuff. And finally, another baby school one. If it ends in 0, yeah, 10's going into it. If you wanted to look at them all together, there they are. Memorize them, make your life easy. Don't memorize them, your life will be hard. You'll be living in a cardboard box under a bridge, eating old chicken bones out of garbage cans. It'll be nasty. Well, maybe it won't be quite that bad, but it'll be easier if you memorize these rules. Factors, a whole number that divides another whole number evenly are factors. For example, whoops, hold on, I need to fix that one. For example, 2 and 3 are both factors. factors of 6. They divide into the numbers evenly. Now we want to take and do a little test here. We're going to test 4,320 for divisibility by the numbers 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, and 9. Why did I skip 7? Oh, I skipped 7 because there's no rule for 7, so it'd be kind of cruel for me to make you do that. And you know me, I'm not a cruel person. You may think I am, but I'm not. Well, maybe a little, but really not. Anyhow, no, we also didn't do the tens rule, just for the simple fact you should know that one by now. So let's test them out. First off, is it divisible by 2? Absolutely, the number is even. How about 3? Is it divisible by 3? Well, let's check it out. 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 0. That's going to give me 6, 9. We got 9. 9 is divisible by 3, so yes, the whole thing is. 4. Is the last two digits divisible by 4? Yes, it is, so the 4 works. 5. Does it end in a 5 or 0? Yes, it does, so the 5 works. 6. Was it divisible by both 2 and 3? Yes, it was, so the 6 works. 320 is, looking at 8, is 320 the last 3 digits divisible by 8? Well, that would be 4 right here, which would be 32. Bring a 0 down. Hey, what do you know? It is, so the 8 works. One last one, 9. Now, we took and added these up a minute ago. When we did, we ended up getting it equal to 9. That was when we were testing the 3's rule. Works the same way for the 9's rule. 9 is divisible by 9, so 9 works too. How's that for a cool little problem? Prime number is defined as a whole number greater than its 1, whose only factors are 1 in itself. For example, 2 is only divisible by 1 and 2. 3 is only divisible by 1 and 3. These numbers are prime. However, 4, that's supposed to be a 4 there, is divisible by 3 things, 1, 2, and 4. It is not a prime number. It is the other one known as composite. Composite numbers are numbers greater than 1 that have 2 or more factors. That's where that 4 came in, because its factors were 1, 2, and 4. 6 is going to end up being 1, 2, 3, and 6. These are examples of composite numbers who has more than 2 factors, a value greater than 1. Well, what about the 1? If it's not prime and it's not composite, what is it? Well, the answer is it is 1. That's it. It is neither prime nor composite. It is an individual on its own. Prime factorization. Writing a number as a product of prime numbers. For example, 20 is equal to 2 times 2 times 5. Prime factorization. And that circle should be down here. I have to make a point to fix that. When you took that 2 times 2 right here, write it in exponential notation, your answer would be 2 squared times 5. Easy math. And we're going to talk in just a second about how we found these factors. So don't get too upset yet. A factor tree is a diagram showing how a number breaks down into prime factors. This is something that those sweet, precious elementary teachers taught you. They would have taken that 20 and they would have said, well, 20's factors are 4 and 5, and 4 breaks down into 2 and 2, so your answer is 2 times 2 times 5. Well, yeah, it works that way, but it's kind of sloppy, and it's easy to lose numbers and get confused. So I use a different method I choose to call upside-down division. And we're going to take and look at two ways of doing the 63. The first way is going to be using that factor tree. Wow, things have really shifted here. That's going to end up being 3 and 21. From there, this 21 is going to be 3 and 7, so your factors Boy, we've missed 3, 3, and 7. And from there, we can take and say it's 3 times 3 times 7, otherwise known as 3 squared times 7 for our answer, greatest common factor. Now, that's pretty sloppy. It would be sloppy even if it wasn't for all my extra writing and misaligned lines and arrows, circles here. Let's look at another way. Let's look at the upside-down division approach. In the upside-down division approach, we're going to start off with the same thing. We're going to write 63. Only instead, we're going to take and put a division house above it. And we're going to take and say, what is the smallest prime number that will go into 63? Well, the answer to that is 3. I like to use the smallest prime number. Technically, you only have to pick a prime number, but the smallest prime number is going to make things easier and more precise. 3 goes into 63. 21 times is 21 prime or composite. It is composite, so let's put a house over it. From there, we're going to say, what's the smallest prime number going to go into 21? It's going to be 3. And 3 goes into 21 7 times. Is 7 prime or composite? It is prime. Now we have our prime factorization. There's the numbers, 3 times 3 times 7. Everything that's outside the house is a prime factor. So it's going to be 3 times 3 times 7, otherwise known as 3 squared times 7. Now, this is the way I had to do this to get the computer to set it up. The way I would do it if I was working it on paper would be true upside down division. I do 63 and I put my division house upside down. 3 goes into it 21 times. Upside down. 3 goes into that 7 times. Same concept, just going another way. You could use either method you want to, but I would encourage that one. Don't use factor trees, though. Factor trees are sloppy. You take and use this one. Find the prime factorization. Use exponential notation to write repeated numbers. Pause your recording. All right, 40. I took and said the smallest prime number is going to go into 40 is 20, or 2, and 2 went into it 20 times. That is composite. 2 goes into 20 10 times. 10 is composite. Smallest prime number going to 10 is 2, and it goes into it 5 times. 5 is prime. So from there we could say 2 times 2, wow, that's way down there low, times 2 times 5, also known as 2 cubed times 5, right down there at the very bottom. Can't really see my circle, so I'll take it off. Easy math. Here's another one. Use prime factorization. We'll find the prime factorization of the number. Use your exponential notation to write repeated numbers. You go ahead and pause it and do this. Okay. The smallest prime number going to 900 is 2. Goes in at 455 times. The smallest prime number going to that is 2. It goes into that 225 times. Hey, that's not even anymore. We can quit. No, we can't. Next, we need is to try out the next prime number, which is 3. Remember the 3's rule, 2 plus 2 plus 5, that equals 9. 9 is divisible by 3, so the whole thing is. So we'll put a 3 in. Oops, I did 5 instead. I wasn't too smart. But when you work it through, there's my 3's in the end. In the end, it makes no difference how you plug them in as long as you're using prime numbers. It'll give you all your pieces parts. But when you rewrite it, you do need to write it in order from least to greatest. Wow, it didn't even show up. I wonder where that went. So I'll go ahead and do that here. We're going to take, and when you rewrite it, it should be 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 5 times 5, which is equal to 2 squared times 3 squared times 5 squared, and that would be what you would circle. Easy math. Now things are getting really exciting. Look at that pretty problem. We are going to start this one just like the others, focusing on the whole number, the 6. We're going to ask ourselves, what is the smallest prime number that is going to go into that 6? Well, the answer is, of course, going to be what? It's going to be 2. And 2 would go into 6 3 times. The 2a squared and the b are going to come up. Next, we're going to ask ourselves, what's the smallest prime number that's going to go into 3? Well, that's going to be 3. And when the 3 get pulled out, then the a squared b moves up. Now it's when things get exciting. What's the smallest prime number that's going to go into a squared b? Well, you have to remember that both a and b represent numbers. Okay? With that in mind, we're going to take and focus on the a. You've got a squared there. So to get rid of that, I'm going to pull one a out, and when I do, the other a goes up along with the b. Because remember, a times a is a squared. See how that works? Now I'm going to take this next a out. I'm going to pull it out front, and when I do, the b goes up. So my factors are 2 times 3 times a times a times b, which you can see right here. Now don't take and write a squared out of those. We had a squared. We don't want a squared anymore. We wanted it factored. So when you have variables, multiple variables of the same type, you do not put them back in exponential form. Give that one a try on your own. The smallest prime number that's going to go into that will, of course, be 3. It leaves a 5xy squared. Then we're going to pull that 5 out because it's prime. It's going to leave x, y squared. Then what are we going to take out? We're going to take out the x. The x is going to come out front, leaving y squared. Are we done? Do we have prime factorization? No, we do not. Y squared is y times y. So we're going to take one y, put it out front, the other on top. Our prime factorization is 3 times 5 times x times y times y. Easy math. Your opportunity to expand your mind tonight, page 199, 5 through 38, and you will find that one on the class website as well. Thank you.